फ्रेंड, वेलकम टू मरीन इंजीनियरिंग हब। दिस इज योर नरेटर रवि गुप्ता। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट कैमशाफ्ट रिमूवल, वेयर वी आर अंडरस्टैंड द कैमशाफ्ट रिमूवल ऑफ टू स्ट्रोक इंजन। आफ्टर दैट वी विल सी द स्मॉल इंजन मीडियम फोर स्ट्रोक कैमशाफ्ट रिमूवल, देन वी विल सी लार्ज मीडियम फोर स्ट्रोक कैमशाफ्ट रिमूवल। सो बिफोर बिगिनिंग द वीडियो, लेट मी टेल यू वन थिंग दैट आई हैव मेट two video regarding camshaft construction and camshaft nomenclature before that this video. So please go and watch that video, which will be shown in the I section, as the video will be correlated. Now let's begin the video of the camshaft removal. So first let me tell you how we are going to do it. First, camshaft lower casing is to be removed. After that, bearing cap is removed, means camshaft lower casing is removed, then bearing cap is removed, and after that the reference mark on the camshaft is verified. Means before removing the damaged camshaft, we need to make the reference mark to be checked. Uncouple and remove the damaged section with the damaged cam. Means damaged section is to be removed with the damaged cam. So basically what I mean to say is this. Here you can see in this diagram, this is the two-stroke man BMW camshaft section. So this is the hydraulic connection, this is the exhaust cam, this is the fuel cam, this is the indicator cam. Now this is one section, and this is the hydraulic coupling the provided with the other section. Now suppose this fuel cam is damaged, this fuel cam is damaged. To remove this fuel cam, what we need to do, we need to remove this whole section, and we need to take it out, and after that we'll bring it to workshop, and then we'll remove this cam. As in place removal of this fuel cam is not possible because of inadequate space. Same thing, this is the soldier engine cam arrangement. So to remove this cam section, we have to remove the coupling. With this is escape coupling, same thing we have to do, we have to jack it up with hydraulically, and after that we have to remove this escape coupling, and we have to take this part out if we have to remove any of the damaged cam. So same thing I have written here. After the reference mark of the camshaft is verified, uncouple, remove the damaged section with the damaged cam. Hydraulic jack is used to remove the coupling at the end nearest to the damaged coupling. So as you can see in this diagram, this is the hydraulic jack provided with the coupling arrangement to removing the damaged section. Okay, now let's see, after the removal of this damaged section, we are bringing it to workshop. What you're going to do, once the coupling is removed using hydraulic jack and sealing is removed, old cam is removed by expanding the cam by heating it with the acetylene gas torch. So this damaged section is brought to the workshop, and suppose this is the fuel cam which is damaged. Now we are heating it up with the acetylene torch, and as it gets expanded, we will take it out. After that, we will place the new one, new camshaft. But before placing the new one, what we have to do? New cam which is to be installed are kept in a heated oil bath and then fitted on position and allowed to be shrunk fitted. So what we are doing, we are keeping this cam, means this new cam, in a oil bath over 210 degrees Celsius for a period of time, so that it get expanded, and after that we are installing it on the camshaft section of that removed fuel cam, and after that it is getting shrunk fitted as it cooled down. After installation, timing is checked and engine is returned to the normal position. So after installation, the timing is checked. How the timing is checked? As I have told you here, before removal, we have checked the mark on the camshaft is verified. This mark is again matched, and the camshaft timing has been again checked with the engine, and engine is brought to the normal position. So I hope you understand how the camshaft removal for two-stroke engine is carried out. Now let's move to the four-stroke camshaft removal. In this diagram, you can see that in a small medium four-stroke engine, camshaft can be replaced as an individual cam removal is costly than the whole camshaft removal. So what I mean to say, I have told you earlier that the smaller engine is made camshaft section is made in section this like this. In a smaller engine, the camshaft are made in section, and if one cam is damaged, so what we are doing, if we are going to remove this particular cam, it will be more costlier to remove compared to the whole section removal. Means the whole section removal is less costlier than removing the individual cam. So same thing I have written here. In a smaller engine, whole camshaft can be replaced as individual cam removal is costly than the whole camshaft removal. Now, here in this diagram, you can see the follower is completely damaged and has stopped rotating. And here you can see the fuel cam is damaged at its peak. So basically, the question comes to our mind that how this condition is reached. This condition is reached only when there is a problem of lubrication. Lubrication problem can occur in two ways. One thing is that lube oil getting contaminated with the foreign particles, means like metal worn out and like that. And secondary is the fuel oil contamination. So the basic thing is that we need to prevent the lube oil contamination, and we need to reduce the lube oil contamination to much more lower extent to ensure that this type of scenario of the damage is not occurred. Now I hope you understand how the small medium speed engine camshaft removal is taking place. Now let's go to the larger four-stroke engine. In larger four-stroke engine, what we are doing basically in this diagram, you can see in larger four-stroke engine, the individual cam is removed. The whole camshaft removal section, whole camshaft damage section removal is very costly. So we are removing the individual cam. For removing the individual cam, what we are doing, this is a grinding jig. Okay, and this is a grinding machine. So basically, suppose this cam is damaged. Now the other area of the cam shaft is been covered with the racks, as you can see here, and this jig is made in place. And after that, we are going to give a cut, okay, in the camshaft. And again, we are going to remove this jig, and we are again rotate it and again place it, and we are again going to give it a cut. And then we are going to take it out with a chisel arrangement. Let me read out, it will be clear to you. This is a grinding jig in position. Okay, as you can see, the jig is manually from side to side. Means what I mean to say, this jig will move from side to side like this way. And the feed inward is controlled by the handwheel. Means this handwheel will control the inward and outward movement of the grinding machine, and the jig will move in this way. Okay. The camshaft and follower is protected by using racks and polythene. When the other camshaft and roller is protected by the racks or polythene. Now, in second diagram, you can see the photo show how the cam is cut in place, and when the couple of mm cut is made, the jig is removed. Means, suppose now the camshaft cutting is carried out for the damaged cam. After a couple of mm cut is made, we are removing this jig. And after that, we are rotating the engine 180 degree. And again, we are placing the jig in position. Okay. And again, after repeating it, we are again giving a cut. And after that, we are taking it out with the help of a chisel. Once the cut is made and the hammering is done, like this, the damaged cam will come out in two section, two half. This point, you can see this is the oil groove where the hydraulic oil will be implemented for jacking it up. But as the cam is damaged to such a extent that this cannot be employed, we are cutting it. Now, this picture show how the cam is cut. This is the two section. This is a one part, top part, and this is the bottom part. In this picture, you can see the circumferential groove for hydraulic pressurizing and adjusting the cam. This is the oil. Okay, hydraulic pressurizing and adjusting the timing. Now, As this part is removed, now we have to place a new camp. But new camp will be split camp type. What is split camp? Let's see. The new camp fitted in position of a damaged camp is split camp type. This is split camp. It means the camshaft is in section joined in place with the help of a bolt. For adjustment of timing, bolt is fitted. Timing bolt is needed to be loosened and then retightened. So what I mean to say, this cam is in two section which has been bolted, and this bolt can be adjusted with the reference to timing and after that retightened. This bolt tightness we need to monitor after a specific running period to ensure that it doesn't get loosened up. Now I hope you understand how we are going to remove the camshaft of a larger 4-stroke engine. Okay, now let's see the part. I hope you have get the idea how the camshaft removal of 2-stroke and 4-stroke is carried out. In the end screen, you will see the two part of camshaft nomenclature and place section of camshaft, where you can click and you can come to know about different other thing about the camshaft if you want to know. And friend, please share the video if you like it. Email credit goes to marinediesel.co.uk. And if you want me to make any video which you want to know, please comment below. Thank you, friend. Have a good day.